So I'd been dimly aware of Verena being here all through that year. And it was only in May of 49, just a month before I had to go back to England, that she got into a car accident somewhere in Lakewood, somewhere close to the shore of New Jersey. She was always bumping into things anyway. And so she had to go there in order to for a court hearing or a fine, or to pay a fine or something. And I agreed to go along just to keep her company and give her some moral support. And so that was when we got to know each other. And it went very fast, because under the pressure of time. So we got madly in love and then had to have a very sad parting. And I remember being terribly downcast. And she actually went off before I did. She had to go for the summer to Illinois or someplace. And anyway, and then afterwards I left for England. We had this very abrupt meeting and an abrupt parting. And then for the next year in Birmingham, when I was in Birmingham and she was in Goucher College teaching, we were exchanging letters almost daily. And so it was a love affair by correspondence, which made life difficult for me in Birmingham. And that was why I never really felt at home anymore in England, because, I mean, I had this strong attachment to Verena, and it was fairly clear that she wouldn't want to settle in England. That we verified the following year. And
when she came?
So in the summer of 40, the summer of 1950, then I came back for the summer school at Ann Arbor, which in the middle of the 2 years, I was allowed
to come back.
To come back for the summer school and to get married. So we got married in Ann Arbor. Then I took her back to England. And then we verified the fact that she wouldn't be happy in England. And it was the second year in Birmingham. She was there with the little girl, and we were all very miserable. And it was, she just didn't acclimatise to England at all. And Katarine was sick most of the time. And so the second year was very difficult.
Mm-hmm.